Hello again, Jeremy Chapman, and with another webcam review. Today we're going to look at the Anker PowerComp C200. I just picked that up on Amazon for about $60, and it's a really nice camera given that it's got a budget price point. So the camera itself is fairly large in terms of a budget camera. You can see one of the cool points of it is it has this really nice privacy shutter. It's very unique to the camera, bright orange as it closes. It's a decent size in terms of the camera itself. It's got a detachable USB on the back using USB-C. The cable itself is also a USB-C to USB-A cable. So if you do have only USB-C on the device side, you will need some kind of an adapter to be able to adapt to USB-C from USB-A. So basically I tried the camera out with all of its default settings, kind of as a UVC camera, and it works without any software if you want to try it. So let's take a look at what that looks like, and then I'll come back and show you some of the other things that I did to dial in the image and get it even better. Let's go. All right, so this is the Anker C200 on default settings, as well as default microphone built into the webcam. I think the sound actually is pretty good on this camera. I would say the lighting though is, even though I'm using the same exact lighting you just saw from the intro scene on my Sony A7, and it's a key light, but it's got a diffuser on it. It's looking very hot on this side of my face, so it's very sensitive to lighting. So let's see if I can do something to actually correct that a bit. Okay, so now I've got my lighting down to about 40% of what it was before. It's on the position 4 out of 10, and it's still kind of blowing out this side of my face and my forehead. You can see there's quite a bit of lightness there, so it's very sensitive to light, but the image looks pretty good again, especially now that I'm kind of in a more low light situation in terms of what's lighting my face. And I've adjusted the automatic exposure. So the automatic exposure, I'd say on most webcams it's set to a -7 or -8 if you look at the Windows settings. This one was set to -6, which is why it was blowing out that side of my face, I think. So now I've set it to -8. I actually went down two different stops on exposure, and now it's looking much better. The skin tones are still a bit pinkish, so I'm gonna go ahead and try a few more things to correct the image a little bit more, just to see how good I can dial it in. All right, so now you saw exactly what the camera looks like out of the box. I tried a couple different lighting settings. It was a bit blown out in terms of its auto exposure. At that point, I looked at the Anker software site. I've got a link here on the bottom of the screen that you can check out to download the Anker software. And once I did that, it actually gave me a few more settings because the camera itself has, a couple of additional settings with it, such as the field of view that you can set. You can also set the resolution of the camera from 2K to 1080p to 720p, for example, within that app. And then once I did that, I tried everything out. I tried to set up the auto exposure because you saw that was kind of an issue with just the UVC camera settings without anything applied to it. And there were no exposure settings, unfortunately, in the Anker Work app. So it still did blow out the side of my face, and I was on exactly the same lighting settings that I'm on right now. But with that camera, it couldn't handle that much light. And even if I turn the light way down to about 40% or 30%, it would still make this side of my face very hot, very white in terms of lighting. So then I dialed in the camera and basically I took it into OBS. I changed some of the filters on it. I put the exposure back down to a better setting and got the image to look pretty good. So now I'm gonna go through some of the settings that I did within the OBS side to dial in the camera. And again, from OBS, the nice thing is you can actually share the camera as a virtual camera into apps like Teams or Zoom or other meeting apps. So you'll be able to use it with those settings applied so that you look really good on camera with all the right configurations in place to really complement the image quality of that camera. All right, so now we've got everything dialed in. I'll just go over some of the settings that I've done. So I actually bumped back the exposure up to -7 in this case, so it's not -8 anymore. On the OBS side of things, in terms of color correction, you can tell I've got the gamma down. In this case, it's -0.17. I've got the contrast up a little bit to 0.2. Brightness is down just a little bit to almost negligibly 0.0132. Saturation, because it was a bit on the pink side, I took that down to -0.15. So now I think the camera looks pretty good, and it, again, it sounds pretty good. One other thing I did though was I actually changed the microphone's directional setting from omnidirectional to just directional in front of the microphone to see what that does. So if you heard a little bit of difference in terms of audio, it's because I changed the settings in the Anker Work.
Okay, so that was the Anker PowerConf C200 webcam. Again, a great camera at about $60 or so on Amazon right now. My feedback, I guess, the exposure setting was a bit of a letdown because you couldn't set it within the Anker Work app. It does definitely need to come down at least one stop, maybe two stops, depending on your setup. I don't have a ton of light on me in terms of my key light. It's a very kind of diffused light, not overly bright, and it couldn't handle that. The other thing was, if you noticed, I changed the microphone settings because I thought maybe going from omnidirectional, which is normally bad because it will catch, you know, the echoes from the wall behind the camera, to a more directional microphone setting, so it just catch the front of me. It actually lost a lot of audio quality that you'll be able to tell inside the video. So it didn't work out too well for me there, but I think the camera on whole, especially with the microphone set up and omnidirectional with just the one tweak to the exposure, is a pretty good value at just $60. So if you like this review, if you got value from it, please hit the like button. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel, and thanks so much for watching.